So guys, today I'm finally going to be doing a review on a pen that I really like. And so this is going to be branching a little bit more back into EDC, and hopefully you guys will enjoy that. This certainly can be used as an outdoor pen. It certainly is capable of doing that. This is a more tactical pen, but today I'm going to be talking about a Fisher Space pen. This is a tactical, like military, Capomatic, because it's a clicky pen like that. Space pen, and this is made by Fisher Space Pen. And I have to say, while a lot of the high-end EDC pen people use these refills, the actual Fisher Space Pen brand, I find, goes really unnoticed in the EDC realm. And I think it's a real shame, because when I was first starting to look for EDC pens, I was wondering if there was any cheap options, or if there were any high value options that, you know, were under $20, but still made in the US, still made out of metal, still high quality, possibly even with that Fisher Space Pen ink cartridge in it. And so all my research actually brought me back to the original maker of the Fisher Space Pen refill, and that is Fisher Space Pen themselves, or Fisher Pen Company, or whatever they're called. I think they just call themselves Fisher, but there's a lot of companies out there named Fisher, so I don't know about that. But anyways, this pen in particular was what really caught my attention, because while you can certainly get some higher end pens upwards of $100 from Fisher Space Pen, you can still find amazingly high value pens such as this one from them. And in all honesty, I've been using this one for about a month and a half now, and I've been purposely trying to really, like, I've been clicking this thing a lot. Like, I flicked this thing over 1,000 times just to see, you know, will it break, will it wear, what will happen if you use it almost, you know, insanely. And I've been, like I said, I've been purposely trying to really heavily use it so that you guys can know long term, you know, will this clicky mechanism fail? And I actually really like the clicky mechanism on this particular pen. It's very interesting because this pen itself actually uses two different springs. There's a spring that's inside down here, which is more of the standard spring that you're used to seeing in a pen, but also this back piece, I'm gonna unscrew it here so you guys can see. This back piece, you guys won't really be able to see it very well, but there's actually two different pieces to this back thing, or this back part of the cap, I guess you could say. And this inside piece is actually the piece that mates and locks. So like that does all the locking in there. And once again, you guys may not be able to see it, but you guys can see, hopefully you can see that movement. I'm not trying to, you know, like mess with that movement, but that is what does all the locking. And I'm not exactly sure what both of these springs do, but hopefully you guys can see that. And then you guys can see here, there is another spring in that side. So this thing actually has two springs. It's a very interesting and very durable, I believe at least durable, way of making a pen. And I found that because it has that inner nested piece in the back here, it does not wear on the actual frame of this pen. So even though you click it, you know, like hundreds or thousands of times, it will not actually wear on the finish or coating of this pen. And I really like that, because while I will say I have tested this coating, it is a pretty durable and deep coating, I still like the whole fact that it does not wear. And like I said, if you watch it really carefully, if you do get one of these, you'll see that this side here is actually not touching the part here. It's kind of complicated, but hopefully you guys get what I mean. So anyways, that is something that I really like about this Capomatic pen. And something though that I really like about this pen is, once again, going back to it, this is an entirely brass, except for obviously the pen piece itself, like the pen ink cartridge itself. This thing is entirely made out of brass, and it's made in the US. So I think that that's really great. I mean, you're getting a full metal bodied pen, and it's made in the US. I forget if it has a lifetime warranty or not. I can't remember if it does or not. I thought it did, but I couldn't find anything immediately. So it might have a lifetime warranty, I just can't remember. But regardless to that, you're getting a, you know, all brass pen made in the US. And I got this one on Amazon for $10. And so I found that to be amazing. And not only that, to top it all off, I'll reopen this thing again. It uses you know, these Fisher Space Pen refills. Now, if you guys have never wrote with a Fisher Space Pen refill, you guys probably won't know, but these do write very well. And not only do they write very well, like not only do they glide across a piece of paper very well, they're also all weather. You can use them in the cold, you can use them in the extreme cold, and in the extreme heat. You can use them, of course, upside down, underwater, regardless to where you need them to be used, because they are pressurized, they will continue to write and the ink will continue to flow out of it regardless to what's around it or the environment it's immersed into. So that's the Fisher Space Pen ink refill, and that is probably one of the largest reasons of why you should get one of these pens, not just because of its awesome price, but the Fisher Space Pen ink refill is a very nice ink. And not only that, it will also write on things like Write in the Rain, which is very important for me. It also is a ballpoint, so it, like I said, it really does glide across a page. Now, it's not quite as good as a fountain pen, but fountain pens can't come close to the amount of usability that this has. Once again, you can't write upside down with a fountain pen. You can't write in extreme colds, especially extreme colds and extreme heats. You cannot write with things like fountain pens in those types of environments. And there's many environments where, you know, things like fountain pens just simply won't work. Now, I will say day-to-day tasks, you know, that may not be as applicable to you, but as you can see right now in this current environment, being able to write in the extreme cold weather is actually a very realistic thing for me. And so that is something that I really do like about the Space Pen refill. Is a very nice refill too. Side internals of it, of course, it is a very basic pen. You know, that is what takes it apart. And you know, there's only three components to this. And so it's very basic. There's nothing to really lose here. You guys can see here more thoroughly the brass. So you guys can see that this is actually made of brass. It has a brass body, brass threads, you know, everything about it is brass. And honestly, I don't find this pen to be that heavy. I will say this is actually quite a heavy refill, but that's largely to do with just how large you guys can see this ink containment. You just wanted to get back to the whole fact that I really just wanted to raise awareness of this pen. And one thing, I was not sent this pen to review. I get no like kickbacks unless you guys use the Amazon link in the description below to buy this pen. I get no, you know, money from this review or anything like that. But overall, when I found this pen, I just wanted to bring awareness to you guys, because like I said, there's a lot of EDC pens out there and they're all really awesome. I mean, Benchmade pens are great, but I mean, you're paying $200 for an aluminum, anodized aluminum pen that uses the same ink cartridge that this one does, and so on and so forth. There's a lot of, you know, other pens out there that you're paying $80, $90, $100, $200 for a pen that's essentially in most ways equivalent to this one, especially when you consider that the ink cartridge is the heart of the pen, because that's ultimately what's going to be making a mark on the piece of paper. You know, that's the heart of it, and this uses it too. And like I said, this is a $10 pen. And then if, you know, that's not good enough for you, you know, it's made in the US and it's made out of brass, so it's not going to snap or break easily. So I really have been enjoying this pen, and like I said, I've been using it hard and purposely trying to see if there's any flaws in this pen over the last month and a half, and I have to say, happily, I've not found anything wrong with it. And once again, the black finish on this, this is like a more tactical model. You can get this in a non-black finish. But I just got it in the black finish because I kind of like the black finish. And once again, I wanted to test that. And even that's very durable. You guys can see, I mean, it's not like I batoned this through wood or anything super hard, but you can see through daily carry a month and a half, this has no major scratches, gashes in this coating. And overall, there are some scratches. If I could show you better, it's all black, so it's very hard to see on camera. But there are some like scratches on the very first layer of this coating. But this coating does appear to be like a multi-layered coating, so it is nice and deep, so that when you do get a scratch in it, you know, little scratches aren't going to show up in it. You'd have to have a really deep scratch for it to really mess up this coating. So that's something else I do really like about it. $10 pen, and it's that, you know, it's that well put together, it's that well constructed. So anyways, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed this video, this quick little video on an awesome pen. do check these out. You know, even if you don't get it from my Amazon link, definitely check these out because they are a really awesome. I really think they're a hidden gem in the EDC world because no one's talking about Fisher Space Pen. No one's using Fisher Space Pen, at least when I see a lot of EDC videos, because I do watch a lot of EDC videos out there. No one's using Fisher Space Pens, but they are a super value option in the EDC realm for tactical pens. Anyways, guys, that's it for now, and I'm out.